Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. So I am gonna talk today a little bit about my experiences on month 2 and 3 of taking the medication Orilissa for my endometriosis. So I was taking this medication as a carryover to get me kind of through dealing with the pain up until I got surgery. And so the months that I'm reflecting on are, let's see, November and December of 2018. I just stopped taking this drug 2 days ago, and so I'm going to talk about my experience up until taking it and the reasons why I stopped taking it. So if you haven't already, I highly recommend going and watching my 1 month on Orilissa, because I'm not going to repeat the symptoms that I talked about in that video. In this one, I still was experiencing all of pretty much those same symptoms that I had initially. I'm going to talk about the symptoms that got worse, but I'm not going to rehash the things I already said. So I'd highly recommend going and watching that video first and then coming back to this after. So without further ado, let's just get straight into it. So as I mentioned in my 1 month on Orilissa, I unfortunately dealt with a lot of hot flashes during the first month of taking the medication. Those hot flashes actually ended up getting worse to the point where they would wake me up in the night. I tried changing the time of day in which I took the medication, but no matter what, I kind of just was stuck dealing with the hot flashes. So I will say those got worse, and I wanted to share that with you. The other symptom that ended up kind of cascading into a bigger problem that I'm probably going to spend most of this video talking about was that I started experiencing a lot of nausea on the Orilissa. So it was around November 15th, I believe, that I went to my doctor complaining that I had a lot of nausea with the medication. And so she said that we should test my liver function just to see if it was elevated as a result of taking the medication, because that is a risk factor with the drug. So I fasted, and I went and I got, fasting means that I didn't eat for a period of time, and then I went and I got my blood drawn to see how my liver was doing. And a few days later it came back that my liver was functioning high, and that means that I had liver antibodies in my blood. And so basically my liver was working in overdrive, almost like I had just gone out the night before and drunk a lot of alcohol, even though I wasn't drinking any alcohol at all. So I basically was feeling like I was hungover 24/7 from being on the Orilissa. And so at that point she kind of said to me, okay, well, you can stop taking it or you can keep taking it, and we can reassess that surgery. And at that point I felt like it was kind of helping me manage my pain, and so I really didn't want to get off the medication, even though it was making me nauseous, because I was right at the end of my semester. You know, it was my senior year, and it was actually my last semester because I just graduated early. I just finished a couple weeks ago, and so I was worried that it would jeopardize that and I would be in so much pain that I wouldn't be able to go to class, I wouldn't be able to finish my final schoolwork, and that I wouldn't be able to graduate early like I had planned. And so I said, no, I'm just gonna stay on the medication and just keep pushing through with that. And so with that, I was nauseous all the time. I was struggling in classes. I was struggling eating and feeling comfortable. I was just kind of sick all the time and really pretty uncomfortable as a result of taking it. Technically, we can't 100% say that it was the Orilissa that made me sick, but now being 2 days off of it and feeling considerably less nauseous, I'm gonna say that it was probably the Orilissa. And then, so that really did help manage my pain for quite a while. And then when I got to December, so this is, the nausea really came about in November, as I said. So moving into December, beginning of December, mid-December, I started having some breakthrough pain. And I want to say that this could have been a multitude of reasons that I had this breakthrough pain. As I said, it was my last semester at school. It was my finals week. I was really pushing my body to the max because I was taking 18 credits. And I was also doing my training to become a doula, which I'll talk about more in separate videos because I want to just keep these about endometriosis. But needless to say, I was really, really busy at that time. And so I think that I might have been pushing my body a little bit hard, and I did have some breakthrough pain in those months, some pelvic pain, some back pain, and quite a bit of discomfort and like borderline misery. I will say borderline misery. I don't need to sugarcoat it. I feel like I can be pretty honest. But I went through a lot and that was not fun. So I kept taking the Orlilssa up until I got my surgery. I just got my surgery and I continued taking it for about a week after. And then when I went to my to an appointment right after I had my surgery, I asked my doctor if I could stop taking the Orlilssa because I just felt like it was making me sick. And I was pretty sick of being on it at that point. And she said, yeah, for sure, you can stop taking it. I really want to name that might be different for other people. I went into taking the Orlilssa, like I said, as a short-term fix until I could get surgery. And then during surgery, I got a new IUD with a higher dose of progesterone to manage my endometriosis going forward. So with that, I don't need the Orlilssa anymore. And the Orlilssa isn't a drug that they give to people long-term. I guess that it's like a short-term thing for 6 months to 2 years. And I was gonna do the 6 month plan, but since it just really wasn't agreeing with me, I stopped taking it at that point. As always, I kind of want to put a disclaimer on this and just say that my experience might be different than yours. You might be doing really well on Orlilssa. You might have had something similar. Either way, I would love to hear what your experience has been. If you have a minute and want to comment down below and let me know how you did on Orlilssa and how you continue to be doing. I saw a lot of people comment on my month one and say, oh my gosh, it works, so it's helping me right now. But I'm curious how it's helping you as time has continued, if it's still giving you the same benefits you were before, or if you're experiencing a lot of nausea like me. And then the other disclaimer I want to say is that you should always talk to your doctor when you're feeling sick. I was really hesitant to go to my doctor and talk about the nausea because I am always nauseous in general. I have just dealt with nausea for a long time, and I've had IBS related symptoms as a result of endometriosis for a long time. And so I was hesitant to even go and complain about the nausea. And then when she heard me mention it, kind of just almost a tidbit of it, she knew that it was more of a problem and knew that we should do those blood tests. And had I not done that, I wouldn't have known how serious the issues could have been. And I might have been doing something like drinking alcohol and causing more stress to my liver. So it's really important to talk to your doctor about these things as they come up, if you feel comfortable doing so. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really appreciate you taking the time. As I said before, please comment down below. Share any questions, thoughts, or experiences you had taking Orlilssa. I would love to hear from you. I so appreciate you watching this video. If you are interested in seeing more, please subscribe and please like if you enjoyed this. Thank you so much. Have a good day.